to the channel. Couple of weeks back, we tackled the contains duplicate problem, which checks if a duplicate exists or not in an array. But after solving this problem, the interviewer might scale things up a bit and tell you that the given array will only store numbers from 1 to n, n plus 1 being the number of elements stored in the array, and that we will always have a single, one and only one duplicate or repeated number. And what you need to do here is find that duplicate number and return it in constant space-time. Okay, some of you may say that this can be solved in the same exact way we solved the previous question in the last video. I dropped the code we previously wrote for you to remember. But now instead of returning true, we return the actual duplicate number the interviewer wants. Some may go even further and get rid of the for loop and use an infinite while loop instead, as we are now 100% sure that a duplicate number exists, so there is no way to be stuck in there forever. This sounds nice, but the trick couple words in this new problem are constant space. You see, this solution works, but it does need to create a set which requires an extra O of n space. So, how do we reduce this complexity? We've made use of all the constraints given except the first one, which states that the numbers stored range from 1 to n. How can we exploit that? Well, I am going to answer this question by introducing the concept of negative marking, which will be useful to tackle this and future problems. Now, since the array only contains positive integers, all ranging from 1 to n, we can track which numbers we've seen before by flipping the sign of the number we encounter. For example, if the input array is the one you see, then while iterating, for the first element, we flip the number at index 2, making it negative. Next, for 4, we flip the number at index 4. And for minus 1, we flip the number at index 1. Finally, when we reach the second 4, we'll notice that the element at index 4 is already negative, indicating that 4 was seen before and hence is the duplicate number. To implement this logic, we will start by iterating over the array, and since we are using negative marking, we must ensure that the current element is positive. This is done by fetching its absolute value. Then we must check if the element stored at the index referenced by our current element is negative. If it is, then we have already performed this operation for the same number, meaning this is the duplicate number. Otherwise, we need to flip the sign of that element, making it negative, and keep looping over the rest of the numbers in the array. Once we exit the loop, we can just return that duplicate number, or we can restore the array to its previous state by setting all numbers to positive, and then proceed by returning the duplicate number. Now, this solution is efficient, linear, and uses constant space. However, the interviewer might further ask you to avoid modifying individual elements inside the array, even if temporarily. So, how do we tackle this additional constraint? Well, to do that, we will have to recall our very last video, the Floyd cycle detection algorithm. And the objective here is to reduce this array to a linked list, allowing us to apply that algorithm on it. I'm not going to dive in the details of the algorithm itself, as we already did that, but I'm going to show you how this array can be transformed to a list so that we may apply the algorithm on it. You see, because the elements stored inside the array all range from 1 to n, then these elements may also be used as indices. So, if we start at the first element, then use that element as an index to fetch the following element, we will obtain 2, then 1 as the first two nodes of the list we are constructing in this example. And because the array we are dealing with has one exact number duplicated, then when we reach this number, a cycle will be created, as you can see in front of you. Now we can apply the algorithm. To do that, i.e. to implement this solution, all we must do is start by initializing our slow and fast pointers to the beginning of the array. The slow pointer will hop one node at a time by using the element it is currently at as the index, and the fast pointer will hop two elements at a time by doing the same thing, but twice over. As soon as these two pointers meet, we exit the loop and reset one of them to the beginning of the list, as we explained in the Floyd cycle detection video. These two pointers will now move at the same speed, allowing them to meet at the element where the cycle starts, which also represents our duplicate number. We can now return any of the two pointers we want, as they are both pointing to the duplicate number. And that's it, the linear time, constant space solution to today's problem. Feel free to play around on LeetCode, as it provides a lot of solutions for this problem. I'll leave the link to it in the description. And let me know your thoughts and suggestions for upcoming videos in the comments down below. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.